my name's Bond.
Her Majesty's best kept secret is revealed. Thursday at 2:40 on ITV.
We focus on manufactured bands at 10:55 tonight in Smash, the story of the British hit single.
Now there's double cream, whipped cream, single cream, custard, custard cream, brandy butter, clotted cream, squirty cream, ice cream, creme fraiche. Mama.
ITV Christmas Entertainment, sponsored by Rennie.
Just a boy in school, I always loved to play the fool. They said it was a childish game, but now I've grown, I'm just the same. That's why when I'm walking out, people always stop and shout. Fun time Frankie,
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 fun time Frankie, I'm feeling fine in a frivolous frame of mind.
The Skinnerettes, ladies and gentlemen. And I know it's a bit late, but Merry Christmas. Yeah. But, do you have any nice presents at all?
You've done well for yourself.
I just got the tie. Now the Thai woman who lives two doors away. Oh, I just made that up. Have you seen these things that they've brought out? I don't know if anyone got these because I think they're quite expensive at the moment, but it's a new invention. I swear this is true. They're called chastity knickers, right? And this Italian bloke invented them, and they're all wired up and stuff. And what happens is that if a woman takes them off for more than 5 minutes, they automatically ring her husband's mobile. Or boyfriend or whatever, but, you know, that's what they do. 5 minutes. They'd never catch me, I'll tell you that. I tell you, if I'm taking 5 minutes, the novelty's already worn off. And how am I getting caught? That's a good idea. What a waste. I'd never do it myself. I'd never ask a girlfriend to wear bloody chastity knickers, God. Some of the women I've been out with, I'd end up having to employ a receptionist. But EastEnders has been good, hasn't it, over Christmas? Been on every day, it seems to me. It's been on. There's one thing about EastEnders which always puzzles me. There's one question which gets asked in EastEnders at least once a week, and I can never work it out. They say, one character will say to another, do you mind just looking after me store for a minute? Every week. And they always say, yeah, okay. And they give them like, the change bib. They put it on and there they are. Yes, love, here we go. Yeah, come on, get here. And they've got the little calls. Hey, you want to get him? We'll send you. Straight into it. I just wish one week someone would say, do you mind looking after me store for a minute? Well, hold on. You know, I don't actually have any retail experience. You know, there's no labelling. How am I supposed to know your pricing structure? Anyone listen to Radio 4 today for the Harry Potter broadcast? Good decision. 8.5 hours it lasted. Stephen Fry read the first Harry Potter book from start to finish, straight through, unabridged. 8.5 hours. And he said, Stephen Fry said, it's the best job he's ever had. He said it was like swimming in chocolate. Yeah, well, I'll take his word for that. They're going to bring a whole series of them, apparently, people reading books all the way through. Next month, Stephen Hawking reads Stig of the Tum. on. Yeah, 37 and a half hours straight through. That's including three pit stops. And they nearly got David Beckham. David Beckham was going to read Spot the Dog. But apparently he withdrew when he found out he had to read it out loud. I'll tell you something. Has anyone... No one's been done for any driving things, have they, over the Yuletide season? Yeah. You know those speed cameras that you get on over, roads mainly? You know the ones I mean that sometimes they flash when you go past? Do you know you can actually demand those photographs? You can actually get the photograph of your car. I didn't know this, but when I found out, it completely changed my attitude to those cameras. This is one I got from the police a couple of days ago. Comes in a cardboard frame and everything. Of course, if 200 people get killed now doing that past speed cameras, who are they going to blame? Muggins. Now, you know, there's some very high-tech Christmas presents knocking about this year, but some people prefer things to be a bit more traditional.
Stupid cyber dog. Will he sneak into the living room and leave it locked? Will he sniff my crotch like it's French perfume? Or go, do you have to leave the room? I don't want to see his eyes flash and hear him whir and click. I want a real dog with a lipstick dick. I don't want to see him sit. Keep that shit. I pass. Can he do that thing when they drag themselves around on their ass? What other toys you got in them two sacks? Next up, Westlife, but this time with an axe.
Now, you know, all my life I've wanted to be able to dance like this. Brilliant, ladies and gentlemen, Jamie Bell.
Wow! It's the greatest that Jack won. Wow! I have ever seen. Wow! It's the greatest dancer. Wow! I've ever seen.
Hello.
Hello, mate.
Oh, can I see her against that settee, you know, all in black?
Sorry.
Oh, for goodness sake, how depressing. Look, I've made a real effort.
You have? It's very nice.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
So, so you started dancing when you were 6 years old?
That's right.
So you were a natural, were you? Did you just...
Well, no, it takes a bit of practice.
Oh, obviously, I didn't say you just strolled straight into it, but they must have an... I couldn't do that dance routine if I'd tried for...
Two months. It took about 3 months.
Did it take about 3 months?
It did.
Oh, I probably could do it.
I don't like heights. That's my sort of...
Oh, I don't want to be falling off an outside toilet.
Oh, no problem. I started when I was six. I started off tap dancing first, and eventually, when I was about eight, I eventually moved on to ballet dancing.
Yeah.
Which wasn't...
Sorry. I know it's a noble art and all that, but for goodness sake.
I know. It was a bad idea, actually, because growing up in the Northeast was a very butch place.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got lots of hassle from the boys at school as well. Yeah, they kind of said poof and all that kind of thing.
Oh, for goodness sake. People are so narrow-minded, aren't they?
They are.
I hate that. So are you?
No, I didn't.
It wouldn't be a bad thing. I just want to say that to the people at home. Well, especially you, mate.
No, but then it just said, no, it just gave me more determination to do it because I just wanted to prove to them that it wasn't just for girls, it's for boys as well.
Yeah. Did you have, like, dance heroes, people who you wanted to be like?
Well, Gene Kelly and Fred Astaire, but...
Yeah, but what about Wayne Sleep?
I didn't really know a lot about Wayne Sleep.
No?
Yeah.
I thought, you see, I can imagine that he would have inspired lots of young boys all over England. So, Dad, we've got a picture of Wayne, in case you don't know what I'm talking about, which is Wayne Sleep. That's him just relaxing. I can't really... Don't look that comfortable. And Michael Flatley, of course, he's the big dancer here, I know that. That's him. Apparently, that picture, that's him just walking. You see him in the park sometimes around London.
Morning, Michael. All right, am I?
Which is very odd. When he takes the dog for a walk, he's constantly being dragged forward with that arm. So you weren't... Have you seen Michael Flatley dance?
I haven't. I saw him in Riverdance in the video, but no, never.
OK. Lionel Blair?
Not very often, no.
No. Got a picture of him as well.
Really?
That's him, that walking. Imagine when he passes Wayne Sleep when they're out walking. All right, Wayne, how are you?
Not bad, Tom.
Oh, it wasn't Wayne, was it? It was Michael Flatley that I mixed up. Yeah. Wayne was over here like this.
Anyway, that's them three, Don.
So you're from Billingham in the northeast.
I am.
What's Billingham like?
Billingham, it's very small, but it has everything you want. It's got a cinema, theatre, a local park. But it's
cheapest place in England, isn't it, to live?
That's right.
That's not fair, is it? Why should there be a film star living in the cheapest place in England? Because presumably you must have a few bob now.
Yeah, yeah. Not a lot.
You get used to it, don't worry about it. They're happy to come round your bloody hotel room after. Well, anyway. It will be in a couple of years' time, anyway. Obviously not. You're 14 at the moment.
I am, yeah.
So are you courting?
No, not at the minute, no.
OK.
No, I don't have time.
How long does it take? When I was 14, it took about a minute and a half, tops.
It's no problem.
Sorry, Jamie.
It's no problem.
No, I know when you're 14, it's embarrassing, that thing. I've kind of gotten used to it. I understand that... well, I've got a quote. Can I read a quote? This is something that you said, apparently, in the mirror. Right? You said...
I know what it is.
You're a telepath. You've got every skill known. It's, can I read it? And you can, if it's rubbish, you can tell me. Just let me get the gags out of it first. I haven't got a girlfriend, though I'm looking at one at the moment. It's like buying a house up there, isn't it?
It's pretty cheap.
You can never judge till you've been inside.
Shut up.
I won't name her, though, in case she gets beaten up.
Yeah, the thing was...
Is it that rough?
Yeah, she was getting threatened because, being the local kind of movie guy.
Yeah. I'm so happy you said that. What a great thing to say.
There's lots of the older girls, they kind of want a piece as well.
Yeah. That's hell, isn't it?
It is, they don't want her going out with me, you see.
Yeah.
So she got threats like, if you go out with him, I'll beat you up. So that was what it meant.
Oh, it's like Romeo and Juliet.
It is.
But so have you sorted that out, or?
No, it's ended. It's...
Oh, sorry I brought it up now.
Oh, that's the problem.
Oh, God, I feel bad about it. I'm over it. So she's still at school, aren't you, at the moment? You're still going to an ordinary comprehensive school. So were they all right with you then?
They were a bit mad when I got back.
The kids?
Yeah, obviously. And the teachers as well.
Yeah. Some of the teachers, they're just caning you for no reason.
That's right. because of the kids that took the mickey out of me before, they kind of don't say anything anymore. But what they do say, before the film came out, they kind of said, or is it like Die Hard 3 or The Matrix or something?
Yeah.
So they were a little bit disappointed when it came out, but... I mean, they're fine now, they don't mind.
But it is it's a brilliant film. It's not a Ponzi film, is it? It's really...
No, it's not really, no.
Because someone... I went to the premiere, you know, so I didn't have to pay.
All right, yeah.
And they said it's a film about a young lad who learns to dance, you know, and I thought, oh, well, there'll be gatto. But I thought it was great.
Oh, good.
Yeah. And there was a moment, if you trust me on this, there's a moment when at the end of the film, it's a packed audience, all sorts of celeb. I mean, Sue Pollard, I think, was there. No, there was a bit, it was a big star night out, wasn't
it? Yeah, it was.
And Jamie walked down the aisle at the end to the front of the thing, and it was like the biggest ovation I've ever heard, obviously, you know, for someone else. It was, though, and that must have been really exciting.
It happened in Cannes. We were in Cannes as well.
Oh,
well,
if it happens all the time, sorry. So you're doing kind of... when people come up to you, then, you know, it's always the things that people say to you, like people come to me and they always say something about football or something like that. When people come up to you and recognise you, is there anything that they usually say?
It's either Dancing Boy or Billy.
Right, but they actually ask you to do a bit of a dance.
They do in America. I've just been in America. And when you go on, like, news channels, they kind of go, do you fancy getting up and doing a little bit of a dance, so I have to do it?
Yeah?
Don't even bother.
And you... Well, I'll be using this, then.
Say oops, upside your head. Say oops, upside your head.
Do you recognise that?
No, I don't.
Do you not? Now, when I was your age, James... Imagine this is Wayne Sleep telling you this story. Now, when I was your age, that was the big disco hit.
Right, OK.
And people would go and they called it the rowing boat song, amongst other things. It's actually called Oops, Upside Your Head. Right, do you know it? Oops, Upside Your Head. What people used to do...
What are you doing? What are you doing?
This is what old people are like.
All right.
Yeah, I'll soon be making jam for you. So what you do? You all sat on the floor. I'll show you if you like.
Go ahead.
Okay. You have to do it with me. I won't ask you to do anything I wouldn't do, and it's not. So we used to all get on the floor like this. You have to sit behind me.
Right. Okay.
Oh, come on. Come on, then. And there's a thing, we need a bit of music, really. Okay, right, it's two slaps here.
Now on all you guys.
And now forward, right?
And you must laugh.
Head to the side. Obviously, been working on that for 3 months. Oh, I enjoyed that. How about you? So, do you?
That's good.
You're still with me, aren't you?
Yeah, Jordan? I'm fine. Yeah.
Okay. I don't need to feel.
No, it's no problem.
Okay. Now, I'm just going to have a drink of water because that was actually quite a lot of effort.
Right.
Oh, thank God it wasn't on an outside toilet. Now you. Are you aware of this, that you're in the top 20 eligible totty, male totty in England?
Yeah, that's right, yeah, I've seen it.
Just spotted yourself there, didn't you?
Yeah, no, I was just wondering who I'd beat, actually.
Oh, you...
Michael Owen there.
Michael, did you beat Michael Owen?
Yeah.
You beat... Oh, yeah, he's... Oh, God, you're... You beat Prince Harry as well. Prince William beat you. But it says Jamie Bell, actor, dancer. Barely into his teens, this youngster is strictly off limits for a few years yet.
Remember that.
But we reckon he will soon be pirouetting into the ladies' hearts. Do you know the ladies' hearts? It's a gay club in Lewisham. Thank you.
It was a joke.
So what's next for you then, Jamie?
I don't know. I've got, well, school really. I mean, I have to get back because I got my GCSEs.
Yeah.
So I have to get back to doing.
You've got holidays at the moment, haven't you? So you've been out building dens and stuff. Do they not do that anymore? Shit. You know what you're missing. Well, Jamie, it's been really nice talking to you.
Oh, thanks for that.
I think you're a good lad, and I hope it. Did that sound patronising?
No,
sorry.
It didn't.
You're not a good lad. You're actually a really good bloke, and I hope it continues to do well. It's a fantastic film. I'm sure there'll be lots more. Win an Oscar. We love you, ladies and gentlemen. Jamie Bell. We'll be back in 1 minute. We'll be back in 1 minute.
We can't get a hold on them. They're untraceable.
Find them.
Who are they?
We've lost them.
Ubo.com.
Christmas wouldn't be Christmas without the Great Escape. Or the special festive offer at McDonald's. This year, the Bacon McDouble at £1.59 and Twisty Fries at just £1.09.
Love it or loathe it,
but the manufactured bands are easier to market.
Plastic rules fantastic in the British charts.
You can probably put a record in the top 20 purely from impact marketing.
Smash goes pop, tonight, 10.55.
Candy butter, clotted cream, squirt cream, ice cream,
Winfrey. Welcome back. Now then, one of the highlights of the year 2000 was the Olympic Games in Sydney. Lots of great moments, but I know what I enjoyed most. Gentlemen, Kylie Minogue. Oh, they love you.
Oh, hello, honey.
Oh, it's gone all America. We're going, wah!
What?
Oh, shit, it's a spider. Oh, no, it isn't. So, it's great to have you on, Kylie.
Thank
that
you.
That must have been a hell of a great gig doing the Olympic Games.
Yeah.
You have a bit of headdress trouble there.
I was
right?
Having a bit, well, a little trouble with the wind.
Yes. Have you tried Windies? In England, of course, we first got to know you through Neighbours.
Yeah.
You don't mind talking about Neighbours, do you?
No.
I loved it. It was great. When you got married, honestly, I cried like a child.
No.
Oh, really? Do you remember that when Kylie married Jason? Oh. Well, just in case you don't, here it is.
Oh, no!
Oh, look, there's Jim. I've got the same hairstyle as him.
Daphne and
Tim. In case you didn't watch the show, former stripper killed in a car crash. Oh, there you are. You look fantastic.
Don't I?
Oh, no, that's you. Sorry. Oh, Kylie. So, you and Jason, did it ever... Was the love there, ever?
Yeah, there was.
You actually were a couple? Because Everyone in England really wanted you and Jason to be a couple, and it seemed like it weren't happening.
I think we played a cagey game of never really saying one way or the other. But, we were seeing each other, and I've got really fond memories of that time because we were best mates, and I don't think there would have been anyone else who would understand what we were going through, the hours we were working, the pressure we were under, the fun that we had, you know, just, it was a pretty crazy time for us.
So, it would have been so great if you'd stayed together and got married and all that. I'd have been so pleased. The two of you on his skateboard. We've got a picture of you and Jason. Just say no, kids, that's all I'm saying. Now, when Neighbours was on, in England, I mean, you must be aware of this now, it was so mega that kids were playing truant from school to watch it and stuff like
apparently.
That.
Apparently. I hear great stories about that.
Well, they even say that it changed the language a bit in England. Do you know this thing?
No.
That English people now, I know a lot of people who do this, they listen to so many Australian soaps, mainly Neighbours, that they go up at the end of the sentence.
Oh, the rising inflection, even if it's not a question?
So they'll say, exactly.
Exactly.
But we're English people doing it. Yeah, so I just went down the pub.
Didn't do much.
Yeah, it's all right down there. I didn't like it.
Well, you got such great words for your vernacular, such as rack off and daggy.
Yeah. Well, all that came
Where would you be without those?
Yeah, I didn't know what a bludger was. Until I watched Alf on Home and Away. You bloody mongrel. We've got a good picture of you, actually, with Craig... Is it
McLaughlin?
McLaughlin, yes. I love this picture. It's very, odd. Are you licking his nipple, or is that my imagination?
It looks more like I'm biting it, doesn't
it? Yeah. And he seems to have one of those cardiograph machines.
It was a new invention then called the Walkman.
Yeah. Oh, I remember that. You know who I played on my Walkman?
Who?
Now, that is my favourite bit.
It's a little hard to do live.
But when you did you actually go, or did they mess about with it after?
Oh, no, they did all kinds of tinkering.
Oh, so you didn't actually go,
No, I'm sorry.
Bloody letdown. I'm sorry. Now, one thing, there was a big thing this year, which in England... Like, do you live in England now?
Mm.
Then you'll know the storm caused by this.
Yes.
Now, it's... So, according to what I read, you actually wore pants for this picture, is that right?
Well, yes, of course I did.
Why, of course? It looks hot there. So, Sorry, I don't have to stare at your bum like that.
Put it down. Well, there's one shot inside where my tennis dress is flying up, and, I mean, I knew they'd be quite... racy pictures between the photographer Terry Richin, a Wimbledon story, and GQ magazine, and me. It was bound to end up like that. But I'm flipping through the magazine. I was even a bit taken aback myself. It's one thing knowing what the picture is and then seeing it in front of you. And I get to this shot where it's, you know, they've obviously tampered with it. And I just said, oh, they've taken my knickers off. Where did they go?
Where is that picture? I don't remember that one. Oh, look.
Save that for later.
Look at that free gel. Fantastic. Oh, I can't. Well, you must have been very upset. Was you?
Well, what could I do? You know, the magazine was already on the.
Oh, but if you got a nice bomb, what difference does it make?
Thousands of stands.
Yeah.
I thought it was more funny than anything. I mean, I don't know. I guess I could have been really mad, but I just thought.
Well, a similar thing happened to me. Wow. No, have we got that picture? I mean, I was tricked. Look. I mean, You can imagine how I actually... Originally, I was just wearing a cowboy outfit. Is it that one?
No.
No? I'll keep looking. Well, oh, what, oh, yeah, no, they've taken advantage.
You see?
Yeah, that is... Oh.
Come on, put it back in the box.
You know what? You don't want this to be shown, do you?
You don't need to see it.
No. I mean, look at that.
Come on.
Yeah, okay, sorry. And did you see the one with the mixed doubles they did in GQ magazine? That was...
What are you looking at?
I'm looking at the airbrushing. Mainly. I do all my own. It's the safest way, Kylie.
It's
let
the
me
only
advise.
Way.
Let me advise you. Now, I've got a quote from you. This is a bit sad, I think.
Oh.
It says, this is in this year's Daily Mirror. At 32, I've come to realise I might never get married or have children. Oh, Kylie. It doesn't upset
well,
me
like
at
it.
All, it says.
No, it's just that people ask me about it all the time, and I used to, you know, I was just younger and more naive in lots of ways, and I would say, I don't know where I'd be in 5 or 10 years, all I know is that I'll have a family one day, and then, you know, yeah, I'm 32, and I just, it's not a sad realisation, it's just a realisation.
Yeah, but you've got ages yet to get married and have kids, haven't you?
Yeah.
Are you courting?
Yeah. So there is a possibility.
Yeah. So, who are you courting with?
A guy called James.
Yeah, we got a picture. He looks a bit like Brian Robson, actually, in a wig. Do you know Brian Robson, the football manager?
No.
He looks like him. But he's a model, isn't he?
He was, yeah.
Oh, not anymore.
No.
You see, I think that's on. I think really good-looking people, because you're a very good-looking person, I'm sure you've been told a million times. Good-looking people, I think, should spread themselves about a bit.
Share the genes.
Well, there's something not right about two really good-looking people being together. You should go with someone who's a bit of a... I don't mean me. I mean someone who's, you know...
Well, no, because you've got to spread the gene.
I've got to spread the comedy gene.
Right.
That's my job. I have to go out with someone who just has no jokes at all.
An absolute bore.
Yeah, and then we can do it that way. But I think you should go out with someone a bit rough.
I have.
You've been out with ugly people?
I've been out with a bit of rough, yeah.
Have you? When was that? I bet that was ages ago.
I can't say that.
No,
well,
you don't have to name
about
them.
Someone.
You don't have to name them, obviously. But since you've been famous, you've done that.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, just for
well,
novelty.
Well, actually, one of the great things, if we were to meet at a bar or, you know, I don't know, at an awards night or TV show, is the comedy gene.
Do you think?
You're onto something, yes.
No, I don't believe that.
It's true.
Now, women always say that. It's really not true, Kylie.
But it is true.
They say, oh,
you
yes.
have a good laugh.
He just laughed me into bed. How do you do that?
As long as they're not still laughing when you're in bed, then you've got a problem.
No, because I find the chloroform stops that. So, you did the Royal Variety performance.
Mm.
I watched it. It was great.
Thank you.
Did you have a? You got to meet the prince and all that.
I did.
Yeah, I got a picture of you meeting the prince. What do you think of him? He don't like the other woman, does he at all? Look at that expression. That is the face of a man who's thinking, is that a bloke? What did he say to you? Did I remember?
Well, he said that he lied to a coat and wasn't doing any more performances. And I said, yes, I'm going on tour and you must come. Do come.
Yeah, he likes your coat. I mean, for God's sake, you meet Kylie Minogue and you say, oh, like your coat. Rubbish. Well, Kylie, I'll definitely come and see you on tour. Looking forward to that.
Yes, you must come.
And it's been great having you on, ladies and gentlemen. Kylie Minogue.
Thank you.
Well, good night, everybody, and remember, love is forever, not just for Christmas. When the
temperature dips. I'm in my baby's arms.
Baby's arms.
His tender fingertips. Know just how to keep me warm.
It may be 0 degrees with the snow falling down,
but I've got warm and tender love just as long as he's around.
It may be winter outside, but in my heart it's spring. How much joy and pleasure, baby,
can one guy bring?
Winter nights can be awful cold without someone to hold.
Someone to hold.
But when I have next to me, baby, I'm in ecstasy.
It may be winter outside, but in my heart it's spring. How much joy and pleasure, baby, can one girl bring?
What a genial, lovable chap I am.
Give him a mince pie.
But there's only 5 left.
Yeah.
ITV Christmas Entertainment, sponsored by Rennie.